Good morning, Saylorville Church. It's my privilege to give just a quick devotional, continuing our series on prayer this week as we lean into the Easter season. I have with me here some letters that Jeannie and I wrote to each other when we were dating. Throughout our dating relationship, we were almost always long distance. I was in California and she was in Iowa. And we would write letters to each other to encourage one another and to tell each other how much we cared about each other and loved each other and how we couldn't wait to see each other. And the letters were very valuable to us, and so we kept them. We still have them here. They weren't something that I could just read and then throw in the trash can when I was done, but we've saved them and we still have just piles of these letters. And that is similar to something that God has showed me this week on the topic of prayer. I want to point out a verse to you. This is in the book of Revelation, chapter 5. It says, it's painting a picture of the throne room of God, and there's four living creatures and 24 elders. And in verse 8, it says, they fell down before the Lamb. Each one had a harp, and they were holding golden bowls full of incense, which are the prayers of God's people. And this sort of struck me. If you've heard this verse before, you've probably heard, hey, our prayers, they're like incense before God. They smell good to Him. It's a pleasing aroma when our prayers are lifted up to God. And that's true, and that's a beautiful thought. But it wasn't that thought that really struck me this week. The thing that really struck me was that our prayers remain before God. Even when we get to the book of Revelation and we're talking about the end times, and it's referenced again in Revelation chapter 8 when Jesus is about ready to come back and inaugurate his kingdom on earth, our prayers are there. They're in a golden censer burning with incense. And it was just this thought that our prayers remain before God, that they're valuable to Him. It's not just like a checklist where God receives our prayers and He says yes to some things and no to some things and then just kind of wads it up and throws it away when it's done. But it's something that God stores up and He keeps it because it's beautiful to Him and valuable to Him. I was reading in this book by Jim Cimbala called The Promise of Answered Prayer, and he says this: when a prayer comes from a sincere heart, it rises into God's presence and it stays there. The more prayers you add, the more they collect in heaven. They don't evaporate like a gas. They remain before God. And it's that thought that it's a little hard to explain, but it's something that's really beautiful to me. That God doesn't view our prayers just as something that He sees for a moment and maybe answers and then kind of chucks them when He's done. But our prayers are much more like this. They're like beautiful love notes that He receives, and He keeps them, and He stores them, and He's got piles of them in heaven, and they burn like incense before Him. So as you pray this week, think of that, remember that, and realize that God, He loves your prayers. He can't wait to receive more of them. And this week, let's commit to storing up lots of heavenly incense in heaven with our prayers.